Hello friends, Sachin Mahesh is back again, and today we'll be doing how to increase your internet speed and have no buffering in your YouTube videos without even contacting or increasing your ISP or internet plans or whatever you call it. So let's take a speed test and see what our current situation without doing anything is. Let's see what our speed looks like. So this is the before doing the trick test, before internet speed. So here I have a download. I'm downloading Hitman Silent Assassin for PC, and I was really stuck at 50 kb per second. Now I am shooting up to 100 kb per second on average. So for this and for the YouTube, you just need to run a command. So let's also see the YouTube test. So here you can see download speed is like 165 from 60 kb per second to this, and it's an immense change on your speed. Now let's go ahead to YouTube and try to watch a video. Let's just check 4K videos and watch this one. So there you have the buffering at the first itself, and also at automatic it's loading at 360. Okay, now that's the start. It started buffering. Okay, buffering. You can feel it's cracking a little bit. And if I change it to quality has gone down to 240p, and if I change it to 1080p, oh my god, it would take forever for me to load this video and watch it. So let's change a little bit of things and let's see what the after effects of the changes are. So the steps you need to do is just simple. Go to command prompt and run it as an administrator, and you will find a command like this on the description of this video. All you gotta do is copy this and paste this and press enter. So you will see OK as a notification after pressing enter. Then you're free to go to the next step, that is running gpedit.msc. So take run and type gpedit.msc. You'll get a dialog box like this, and go into administrative templates tab and go into network, QoS packet scheduler, and limit reservable bandwidth. Most probably it would be a disabled or not configured. Just enable it and change this AD value to 0 and apply and OK. And you're free to go to the next step. The next step will be changing your internet protocol version for DNS address. The faster DNS server that you're connected to, the faster speed you get. So to do that, you need to right click on your icon, open network and sharing center, local area connection, properties, internet protocol IPv4, and most probably you'll be having this, or you'll have some values here. Just replace with the value that I'm going to type now, 208.67 and 222.222, and alternate DNS server is 208.67 and 220.220. Okay and okay, close it and refresh. If you want, you can restart your modem also, but I'm not going to do that. So after doing all that, just let's check the speed test, and you can feel the internet has been flying right now at the speed. And let's begin the test and see if we got any change on our results. Okay, that was fast, 1.67 at the start, and also it's stable. So there we have the test results, and we have 1.24 MB per second download speed and 0.70 Mbps upload speed. But I don't know why it was 1.6070 at the first and it dropped down. You can see the graph. It was stable at the first, then it came down. I don't know, for some reason it did. But it had an immense effect. And next is our YouTube test. So the same video, let's see the 4K videos, and let's see the same video that we saw. And let's, oh my god, you can feel it, the video buffering thing never, oh, you can literally see the white thing is having a race with the red one. So, and also the quality is at automatically at 480p, note that. And also I'm going to change it to 1080p. And now, when before we were struggling to get a 360p without buffering, but now the same time the 360p takes is the same time that 180p takes. So that means you could watch 4K with less buffer. So the video has started loading and you can see there's a bit of a buffering, but it would just go, you can, a bit of a buffering, a little bit, but it had changed. It has changed a lot. And if I do an automatic again to show you back, the quality is at automatic and now it's running at auto. It's still at 360p. It can sometimes go to 480p and 720p. So that's how you do the trick. So before, you can see here, before we had speed very low, but now you can compare with these two and see the change. So if you really like this video, don't forget to press that red button. It motivates me and makes me do more.